1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're going to rock around 10 o'clock tonight. Put your glad rags on. Join me, home. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes 1. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. We're going to rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. When the clock strikes 2, 3 and 4, if the band slows down, we'll yell for more. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. We're going to rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. When the chimes ring 5, 6 and 7, we'll be right in seventh heaven. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. Oh, when it's 8, 9, 10, 11, 2, I'll be going strong and so will you. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight.
So what game did you get for the 50s party?
Voyages of Marco Polo. Yeah, so it turns out not a lot of games are set in the 1950s.
So should we just take all this off then?
Please don't.
In Voyages of Marco Polo, you'll take on the role of a traveling merchant from Venice, trekking along the Silk Road and establishing your own trading empire in the Orient. You'll go from city to city, trade valuable silks and spices, and fulfill contracts to become the top merchant in the land.
Just trust me, this game is great. Now, just close your eyes, and it'll be like you're back in the age of Marco Polo.
Imagine yourself in beautiful 13th century Venezia, a bustling hub of trade and culture in Italy. Each player gets a character tile with different special powers.
You can draft the tiles, choose from a random two.
Oh, I am so sorry, my friend.
No problem. My fault.
Thanks. If I may say so, you look rather lost.
I'm supposed to meet someone here.
Of course! Your exotic manner of dress, you must be the young boy that I sent for. With your help, all of my fantasies will come true. Come, let us mount.
Wait, no, no, wait, what?
I am sorry, let me introduce myself. I am Mercator Extabris, merchant extraordinaire. I have spent years selling my wares here in Venezia, but now I wish to expand. That is why I have hired you to help me travel across the Orient. You see, I had a dream many years ago, a beautiful dream of the future. This is a map of the Far East. In my dream, I opened trading posts in these four cities. It has been my life's goal ever since to make this dream a reality. One shop would be lovely, two would be better. But if we were to found three, surely word would spread, and we would become the most successful merchants in the land.
Sorry, Tabriz. Can't help you with three.
Oh.
We're gonna get you all four.
My friend, you have made me so happy. Now, we depart. To the camels.
Camels?
Well, it looks like Jack has attracted a strange man, and they're wandering off together.
Okay.
Here are the remaining character cards. Everyone find your guy and we'll meet up at the first oasis.
Okay.
Your character will greatly affect your overall strategy, so you want to make sure you get one that suits you.
You there! I need to reach Beijing and quickly. How much to hire your rickshaw?
How much you got?
10 coins. Will that be enough?
Seems fair.
You come around fast, can't you? I mustn't be late.
Absolutely. Watch.
Hey!
Each player starts with 2 camels and 7 to 10 coins, depending on your player order. With this modest start, it's up to you to figure out how to travel across the land and trade your way up to the big leagues.
Excuse me.
Hey. Come on, I'll take you to Beijing.
Oh, thank you. I'm Kokochin, the Blue Princess. Delighted to make your acquaintance.
Okay, Princess. But we're taking camels.
Oh, of course.
The game takes place over 5 rounds. At the beginning of each round, you roll your pool of 5 dice. Then the players take turns performing one action by placing dice on the corresponding space of the board. The value of the die determines how many times or how much of an action you can perform. So the game is about managing the values of your dice to make the most out of each round. Kind of like a worker placement game, but some of your workers are super productive and others are lazy fucks.
Oh, I almost forgot. The first player token goes to the person who last embarked on a voyage around the world.
Yeah, that's fun.
Yeah, flavor win. So, who went somewhere?
I haven't left the house in months. The kitties would miss me too much.
Oh, does sex tourism count?
No.
Oh.
I went to Taco Bell for lunch.
Really? Wow, where's your sense of adventure, guys? Like, what do you even do with your lives?
Sit around with you playing board games?
Touché. Well, I guess it's me then from when I went to Kenya and the Hyena Project.
I thought you said sex tourism doesn't count. Placing dice on the movement track and paying the... paying the corresponding travel cost allows you to move that many spaces. Once you reach a city, you automatically build a trading post there, unlocking that city's unique action to use on future turns.
Kinda hard to roll these bouncing around like this.
Rolling is for fools. Just set the dice however you want.
Oh, is that what all those X's mean?
Doesn't that sort of betray the spirit of the game, though?
What do you know of betrayal? Some folks call me traitor. I'll show them. I'll show them all.
So I'm just gonna put this out there. Are you evil?
What? Of course not.
It's just that you're always polishing that knife and going on and on about being a traitor.
No, I said traitor. Yes. I wish to open a series of shops. Knife shops.
But you only have the one knife.
Everyone has to start somewhere, don't they?
Okay, cool. Hey, you know what? I'll be your first customer. How much for the knife?
It is not for sale!
Okay.
I must deliver this knife directly to the Khan himself.
You see that right there? It's totally an evil laugh.
In addition to travel costs, some routes also require you to spend camels or additional money to traverse them. These will be marked on the map.
Ormuz, city of opulence, good manners, and most importantly, trade, the jewel of the Arabian Desert.
So what are we waiting for? It's the first city on your map. Let's go!
Oh, the route is too treacherous. We need more camels.
Tabriz, there's only 2 of us. How many camels do you need?
3. I am sure of it.
That doesn't make any sense. Look, it's right there. Let's just go. Come on, look. See? Come on, Tabriz. Come on. Yeah. Oh.
Not to worry. I know where we can obtain more camels. To the bazaar. We might also be able to find you some medicine to repair your bones.
Thank you.
The bazaar is the main way to obtain the exotic goods of the East. Camels, pepper, silk, and gold are all for sale for the buyer with enough dice to spare.
Camels! Get excuse me. Camels here! Gold for
sale! Pardon me. You haven't bought anything yet? We gotta get moving.
Patience, my friend. I have spoken to many traders. The wheels are in motion.
You can place an order at the bazaar by placing dice on the corresponding space. More valuable goods will cost more dice, and higher dice values will provide you larger transactions. Once obtained, goods can then be used to fulfill contracts, earning victory points. You can keep any number of goods in your inventory, so don't be afraid to stock up.
Why do we need 10 pallets of silk to go to Beijing?
If you must know, I have a lucrative contract with Kublai Khan, and the silks are to sit on. All this camel riding is chafing my bottom region.
Can I see it?
That's improper.
I meant the contract, princess.
Oh, it's private.
Contracts are another way to earn victory points. Each player starts the game with one, but can claim more as the game progresses. The left side specifies the goods needed to fulfill it. Once the goods are paid, the contract is completed, and you gain the victory points indicated on the right side.
Got enough stuff there?
What's that?
Oh, it's a three silk. All the goods have tokens representing three. They're so compact and convenient.
Uh-huh.
Thank you. Much appreciated, my friend.
What? How are we getting all this free stuff?
Ah, I have contracts with all the vendors in the city. I introduce buyers to sellers and make proceeds of every sale. Oh, thank you.
Look at all this! Tabriz, you're a genius!
You are too kind, my friend. Trade isn't about wares, it's about negotiation. Bring the right people together, and the goods flow all by themselves.
And one of these. That ought to keep you from running off again.
Okay, look, you were being pretty insufferable. It was just a harmless prank.
A prank?
Yeah, you know, a way of putting stuffy people in their place. Like a pie in the face or a banana in the tailpipe?
Banana in the tailpipe?
Yeah, that's a classic way of sabotaging someone's car. Caravan.
So, they all involve food?
Not always.
You poor folk. Common folk. That's what you like to be called, right?
Or George.
George. Well, I think we have everything we need here. Are you ready to go?
We'll have to wait until the next round. Spent so many actions on the bazaar, we don't have enough dice left to travel.
You have a die right there.
Yeah, but it takes two dice to move, plus a ton of coins. Hate to break it to you, princess, but traveling's one of the most expensive actions in the—
You, sir. Could you give us a ride to the next oasis, please?
Abso-fucking-lutely.
Oh, do you have room for my goods? And my manservant?
Yeah, no problem. I'll load it up for you, miss.
Thank you. Was that so hard?
Whoa. You get to move her for free just by putting one die on her?
Apparently. Later, losers.
That's super broken.
You're one to talk. You're the guy that just lets you use whatever dice values you want.
True, but I think he might be trying to assassinate the Khan.
That's racial profiling. Just because he's a creepy old Middle Eastern guy with a beard, you assume he's gonna kill someone?
Rashid al-Sinan literally started the Hashashin.
Okay, he happens to have founded the Order of Assassins.
Hey, maybe you could stop him. Think about it. If you save the Khan's life, I'm sure he'll give you tons of money, jewels, property, you name it.
Tons of women, you say?
I did.
I'll do it!
As the game goes on, you'll see that five rounds goes by pretty quickly, so you'll have to make some tough choices in how you manage your actions. If you focus on completing contracts, you'll miss out on a lot of bonuses and actions from all the city cards. If you focus on exploration, you might be able to make it to all the cities on your goal card, but traveling multiple spaces at once gets increasingly expensive.
Well, then I said, none of your falcon business!
Good one.
I figured you of all people would appreciate that one. After all, your name means, well, falcon. Extraordinary! To think that I would meet someone like you in my travels. You know, falcons are nature's most fascinating creatures.
Hey, we're kind of falling behind. You want to set up shop here?
Can it be a falcon shop?
Okay, shop's up. Let's just keep moving. Hey, what happened to all our camels? I thought we had two left.
I traded them.
You traded our only means of transportation? For what?
This falcon. You know, I've always wanted a falcon of my own. I've named him Little Hana, after you.
Awesome! Except without camels, we can't go forwards or back. You've stranded us here.
Not to worry. Falcons are trained for this very probability. Go, Little Hana! Get us help! Fly! You know, I don't suppose he was trained yet.
Get up! We gotta go!
What? It's not even light out. What happened to my camels?
They bailed on us! Come on!
We can't ride the same camel.
Unless you'd rather wait here and get blasted by a sandstorm, you don't have much of a choice. Just get on, princess!
Mm.
Yeah!
Did you know that the peregrine falcon can dive at speeds of up to 320 kilometers
per... Shut up! You need to shut up about the falcons, okay? Ever since we met, every word out of your mouth has been about the fucking falcons!
Oh look, little Hannah's back! And she brought the free city bonus card with her!
City bonuses are action spaces that can be used if you control a trading post on that city. Unlike most other actions, they're limited to one player per round, so you'll have to compete to get access to the good ones. Some characters even get a number of city action bonuses for free as their special ability.
This is great! That little bird came through! All we need now is one more.
She appears to be shredding the card to make a nest!
That's...
wonderful! She intends to remain here for the season! We are quite fortunate to see this behavior firsthand, don't you think? Splendid!
Your work is... you're an inspiration to me!
I inspired this MS? I should hope not!
Yeah! Learn to explore the Orient, noobs!
What? Why, they're not nice people at all! My contract expires soon! If we don't make it to Beijing in two more rounds...
I got an idea. Come on.
If you're low on camels, you can always travel by sea. The lower area of the map allows for quick travel along the southern coast, but booking passage on ships is expensive. Fortunately, some action spaces can provide you with a bit of extra income if you're willing to work for it.
Damn it. 15 coins to book passage. How much do we have left?
10. I can talk to the ticketer. Try and get us a free move.
No, your pussy pass won't work here. We'd still have to pay the full travel fee.
Those two again!
Wait, I have an idea. How dexterous are your hands?
I'm a princess. What are you suggesting?
Just follow my lead.
What do you think of these for my next book? The Spectacular Voyages of the Incredible Marco Polo and Associates.
Your fans will love it!
Marco?
Oh, speak of the devil. Hello?
Hello!
Tio, who's there?
Marco!
Niccolo, do you hear that?
Hear what?
Polo!
Show yourself at this instant! Marco Polo commands you!
Marco!
I think he's over here!
Polo!
Get your face out here!
Marco!
Testa di cazzo!
After you, princess.
Oh no, my lord, after you! Maybe he should call his book The Spectacular Hallucinations of the Incredible Marco Bozo.
The first player to reach Beijing gets 10 bonus points for building their trading post, with progressively less points for each subsequent trader. An alternate end goal is Sumatra, which doesn't provide points, but has a whopping 3 city bonus actions to use.
Okay. I completed... one more contract, and use my free move to go here. One space away from prime Beijing real estate.
Look! They're almost to Beijing!
Yeah, he's making a beeline for it. It must be his last goal.
He can't make the crossing, though. He doesn't have enough camels.
Well, yeah, not yet, but he just needs one more. He can get that by next turn.
Unless we put him in his place. Leave this one to me.
No camel for you.
That's a dick move.
Yes, it was. See you in Beijing.
Looks like those camels won't be taking him anywhere now.
What did you do?
I pranked him. You know, the classic banana in the tailpipe.
Camels don't have tailpipes.
Okay, last round.
Wow, down to the wire.
Yeah, we're all neck and neck. Oh, except for Hana. She's way behind. Like, super behind. Like, I don't even know how that's possible. Well, on the bright side, I bet you learned a lot about...
Say the word falcon and your scrotum goes through the garlic press.
My bad.
The final round of the game is hectic, as each player scrambles to finish their long-term goals while cock-blocking others from finishing theirs. At the end of the game, 7 bonus points are given to the player who completed the most contracts.
How much longer are we doing this?
Okay, this may come down to who has the most contracts. What's the status on yours? Are you close?
I have everything I need.
Wait, this is a contract for you.
My arranged marriage to the Khan.
This is why you came to Beijing? Wow, 9 camels and a gold bar.
I don't fetch a bad price, do I?
Next.
I have something for you, my Khan.
No!
Got him!
Rashid, my loyal friend, you have brought back my family's cherished heirloom. Truly, you are a great and honorable man. I shall bestow upon you a plot of land to open your very own shop, right here in Beijing.
Thank you, my Khan. It has been my lifelong dream.
Huh. And you, stranger, for assisting him, you shall have 6 barrels of my finest wines.
Wives? All right. How many come in a barrel?
He said wines.
Oh.
Well, we're next. Are you sure you want to go through with this?
I don't have a choice. It's a signed contract.
Finally, made it. Where's my 7 points?
You're 3rd. Brandon's already here, too. So you get 3 points.
So I'm last. Great.
Hey, you still beat Hana.
Who gives a shit about Hana? You know what? Fine, whatever. You may have made it to Beijing first, but you know what I got on my voyage? Expertise. I learned more than you 2 will ever know from the Mercator, ex-Tamil El-Fadig.
That is not my name, friend!
Shut up, Tamil! You see, I am a master trader, and that means...
Oh, well, you got us beat then. We're not even gonna be able to complete our last contract.
Oh, yeah! It's a doozy, too. 10 points. Oh, well. Guess we just have to throw it away.
I'll give you 2 camels for it. Okay, 2 camels and a silk.
Done.
You fucked up. Now I have enough contracts to win the game. You see, George, this is how smart people do business. You want to be the middleman. Get your fingers in all the pies. Excuse me. My call. Our contract.
My son. Terminator Sos Chiulus Larga Tolo Gotoyum. Neguda tunic Poloshadog.
Wait, where are we going?
To the harem.
All right!
Is he really going to win?
Well, he does have the most contracts. But if we hit one more city, our last trading post gives us 10 points. And where he's going, I suspect he is going to be the middleman. With fingers in all his pies.
Ultimately, Voyages of Marco Polo is about finding your own way in the world. Be it trading or exploration, via camel or boat, your destiny is your own to decide, and your dreams to fulfill.
So, where to now, princess?
I hear Sumatra's nice this time of year.
Sumatra it is.
To the north! Yeah!
It's south.
Yeah, I knew that.
Voyages.